Hey there, my name is Isha, and in this video, we'll explore how to create custom views for blocks. Custom views are used to override the AngularJS view for the block list in the content editor. So let's start. In the previous video, we created a simple block list and rendered it on the front end. This is how a block list looks in the content section. We can improve the editing experience by overwriting the default representation of our block entries with a custom view that provides a better view of how the content will look on the front end. To begin with, let's create a custom view. We'll create a new folder inside the App Plugins folder and call it Custom Views. Inside this folder, we'll add an HTML file called custom.html and add some basic configuration to it. What I'm doing here is I've added an ng-click directive which will apply the behavior when the block is edited. Next, I'm displaying the properties of the block which is stored in block.contentData.featureName and feature description, which is the alias of my properties. I'll save the custom view and restart the application. To assign the view to the block, we'll go to Settings and open the product document type. We'll scroll down to the bottom and click the cogwheel next to product features and select block list. We'll add the custom view to the product features block, and in the configuration window, we'll select add custom view and browse to the custom.html file. Let's submit this configuration and enable the live editing mode so we can view the content as we type. We'll submit the settings and save the document type. Let's go back to the content section and navigate to our product node. If we scroll down, we can now see the feature name and feature description as listed in our custom view. So, we've overwritten the AngularJS view for the content editor's block presentation by using our own view. Now, when you click on Add Content and select Product Features and enter the feature details, you'll notice you can view the content as you type. This is because we've enabled the live editing mode. Now we know how to create custom view for our blocks. In a similar way, we can alter the content that is displayed by using the settings module. Let's create a settings section to hide the block in the front end and control the data alignment of the block. To do this, we need to add a settings module to our block configuration. We'll go to the settings section and right-click on the document types and select element type. We'll enter a name, let's say feature settings, and give it an icon. We'll create a group and call it settings. Let's add a property and call it hide block and select true false as its editor. We'll add another property and call it block alignment. And add dropdown as its editor. In the pre-value field, I'll add left, center, and right as its value. Let's submit the property and save the element type. We need to update our style sheet to use the alignment configuration. So, in the style sheets folder, I've updated the style sheet to include the values we just defined. We'll now assign the feature settings and the style sheet to our block. So we'll go to the product document type and edit the block list. In the product features, we'll select the custom style sheet and add style sheet to it. We'll browse to our style sheet. And in the settings module, we'll add the feature settings element type that we just created. Let's submit the configuration and save the document type. Next, we need to update our views. To render the hide block property on the front end, we'll go to the product features partial view and uncomment the settings line and replace the alias with feature settings element type. And below, we'll just add an if condition to check if the block is not hidden, then we'll display the block details on the front end. I'll just align this a little bit. Cool. I think it's fine. Let's save the partial view. For the block alignment, we'll update our custom HTML view file. So I'll stop the application and add a new line and add a div tag here, which is using ng-class to bind the data. We can access the properties of settings by using block, which has settings data, which contains my property alias, that is block alignment. And I've added the values left, center, and right to bind the data. I'll close the div tag here and save the view. Cool. Let's restart our application. So now when we go to the content node and hover over the block, we should see the settings option. Yes, there it is. When we click on it, we can see the hide field option and the block alignment dropdown which we created. Depending on the dropdown selection, you can see the changes in the view. Let's confirm the changes. You might notice that the setting is applied to only one block. That's because the settings are unique to a single block. You can set different settings for different blocks. Also, we do not see the settings option for code block since we have not added the settings element type in the settings data model configuration of the code block. Cool. Let's save and publish the document type and see the hide block setting in action. So we'll refresh the front end. And there it is. We can no longer see the block on the front end. In this way, you can create custom views and settings section for blocks. You can let your imagination run wild and try creating and customizing blocks as per your need. That's it for this video. If you wish to learn the best practices and take advantage of the latest Umbraco features, you can sign up to the Umbraco Fundamentals training course. I'll leave the link in the description box below. Stay tuned for more videos.